biathlon made its debut at the Universiade at the inaugural event in Sofia, Bulgaria, back in 1983. Success in the Universiade has proved a launching pad for a number of biathlon greats. They include Olga Zaltseva, Thomas Sikora, and Olga Nazareva. There are 9 events in this edition. A bright, crisp Sunday morning at Lago di Tesero, a site well known for hosting cross-country skiing competitions, saw the men's 10-kilometre sprint. One of the favourites was the Serb, Milanko Petrovic. He collected bronze in Friday's 20-kilometre race and was eager to try and move up a step or two on the podium. His shooting let him down badly in that 20-kilometre race, and there were a few nerves when he missed one on his opening loop here. The 25-year-old student at the University of Kragujevac already holds a special place in his country's sports history. His appearance at the 2010 Winter Olympics in Vancouver, making the first Olympic biathlete for an independent Serbia. But the Ukrainians have a proud record in this event. The last time they failed to win a medal was back in 2001. Since then, they've taken 1 bronze, 3 silver and 2 gold. Most recently, Artem Firma, 2 years ago. This 25-year-old Vitaliy Kilchytskyy, student of Lviv National Physical Training University, putting himself in a great position to add to that tally. Also putting himself in the mix was another Ukrainian, the 22-year-old Dmytro Pidruchnyi. Pidruchnyi, another athlete with World Cup experience, did well in the 20 kilometres, coming in 9th, but he looked more comfortable here in the sprint. He's a student at the Ternopil National Pedagogical University, learning to be a teacher. Certainly looks as though he's been taking a masterclass in shooting and obviously in skiing. Pidruchnyi, certainly one to watch. Fu Yancheng flying the flag for Chinese Taipei. Sadly, he wasn't quite good enough to trouble the top flyers. The same goes for the Australian Alexei Almukov, although he's shown some real consistency, 10th in the 20k, and he came 7th in this one in the 10k. Great effort from the man from down under. Well, the final running came to the big three. Pidruchnyi was the first of the challengers to cross the line. He came through in a time of 25 minutes 38.2, and that meant real disappointment for the Russians. The best they could manage was Alexander Pachenkin. He was the best of them. He came in another 8 seconds further back to take 4th. And that's the first time since 2001 that the Russians have missed out on a medal in this event. Pidruchnyi's effort only good enough for the bronze, as Kilchytskyy bustled across the line in 25.33 dead, 3.5 seconds quicker than his Ukrainian teammate. Certainly his best result this season, improving on his 5th spot in a 20-kilometre event in Baitostolom. Pleased with the silver, but the question was whether Petrovic could get over his jitters with the rifle and snatch the gold away from the Ukrainian. His World Cup experience showed at the end as he kept a cool head, produced a quick finish to hit the line in 25 minutes, 29.5 seconds, 3.5 seconds faster than Kilchytskyy. A first gold medal for Serbia at these games, and a great moment for Petrovic, as he showed us there. A very happy man indeed. And hopefully for him, it won't be his skis that are the only thing he kisses after this terrific win. So there you have it, gold for Serbia, silver and bronze for the Ukrainians, and the Russians go home empty-handed. Vegard Begli showing well for Norway in 5th. We'll see more from them in the biathlon as the competition progresses. There are 2 more men's events in biathlon still to come, a 12.5k pursuit and a 15k mass start, as well as a mixed event. Time enough, not just for the Norwegians to shine, but for the Russian bear to growl again.